and extend the session to all. Briefly itself, explain. You can read.
So in this song, Sri Rupa Goswami is explaining his goals and...
You can come. You come late, daily. No, Madam Rabaji.
Saying, Manamanasa Madhukara Marapaya Nijapada Pankaja Makarande. I'll read first the translation. O Bhagavan Sri Krishna, I'm offering a prayer to you. Please attach the bee of my mind to the nectar of your lotus feet, meaning please let it have a taste of the rasa of those lotus feet by which it will then never be able to become attached to anything else. So actually it's a prayer of a very elevated stage where he's feeling so much want for this taste of Krishna's lotus feet, and he's feeling himself that he's so helpless and his mind is wandering in so many different directions. It's just for our teaching. Of course we know that Srila Rupa Goswami is past position, he's the eternal associate of the Lord. But to guide us, he's playing the role and he's telling this nice prayer. And if we also try to absorb ourselves in his moods, then by his mercy, because it is written by him, so Krishna will definitely hear these words. He may not hear our prayers, but if we repeat these words, then gradually this mood will arise in our heart and we will develop a same attraction for the lotus feet of Krishna, which Rupa Goswami Pada is mentioning here. And then he goes on to say, Yadhyapi samadhishu vidhirapi pasyati natav nakhagra marichim idam ichhami nishamya tavachut tadapi kripad bhutivichim. Although Brahma in his samadhi cannot obtain a glimpse of even a ray of the tips of the nails of your feet, still, he Achyuta, having heard of the waves of your astonishing mercy, I yearn to see you. So as we hear often description from Lotus Mahaprabhu Srila Gurudev also, and it seems that these topics, not just topics, this realm of devotion is so far, and when we compare our position, we are so fallen, completely engrossed in our bodily consciousness and always hovering on the mental platform, sometimes feeling enthusiastic, inspired, and other times we are again doomed and depressed. So when we hear this and the exalted stages, then sometimes it feels that, oh, what's the hope? There's no hope. And then we see even Brahma, who is the creator and is also our Adi Guru, even if for him these things are too difficult, then what is our hope? Where do we come and count? We don't even come in the line. So in order to still inspire us, Srila Rupa Goswami Pada is saying this, that Krishna's inconceivable potency, his causeless mercy is so powerful that if feeling so much helpless, feeling so humble down, if we pray with folded hands and with all our gratitude and pray in this line, in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami, then certainly we can have this. There is no doubt about it. So being sure of this, having full conviction in these things, if we recite this word, then surely this causeless mercy of Krishna will benefit by this mercy of Krishna and we will be able to get this thing. Then he's saying, Bhakti rudanchati yadhyapi madhav natvai mamuti lamatri parameshwarata tadapi tavadhik durghat ghatana vidhatri. O Madhav, although I don't possess even a sesame seed of bhakti for you, by your supreme power, which makes the impossible possible, please fulfill the desire of my heart. So again, he's repeating the same mood. And if we hear the true definition of bhakti, which is para bhakti, shuddha bhakti, kevala bhakti, prema bhakti, when we hear these things, then we see that it's too difficult for us because that is completely on a spontaneous platform, and we hear that Srila Bilwa Mangal Thakur has been accounted to be a sadhak, is a beginner of sadhak. So what are we doing? We are not even doing sadhana. And when we hear about this Shuddha Bhakti, it's too difficult. And we also hear that unless we develop a certain particular type of greed, we cannot have this. Now here Srila Gurudev is explaining again and again that though we are completely disqualified, we are not qualified, we are unqualified for these things, but the nature of bhakti is that it does not expect any eligibility conditions in regard of some qualities, like some may be very pious and maybe very truthful, honest, and maybe very pranadati, very tolerant and all these things, so that person only is subjected to bhakti. It's not like that. A person may be fallen as jagai madhai, and if we see our position, then we are even more fallen than him, if we really realize it. So what is our hope? So then it's said that if still by the association of some rasika bhakta who is completely saturated, Mahal gives the example of rasagulla, like a rasagulla, if he is saturated like that, and if you are fortunate enough to get the association of such devotee, then by his association you can have a greed to serve Krishna in Braja, like Nanda Yashoda, like Gopis, like his sakhas, and that greed itself is so powerful that it will attract this spontaneous devotion in our heart, and one day sure we will progress in this path of devotional service. So this is the potency of Krishna's bhakti. That is, this is the inconceivable potency which can even make things possible which are impossible. And this is the most impossible thing. Because we are completely conditioned soul, how can we have this? So this is the most impossible thing which can still be made possible. And in the last verse he's saying, I am a vilola tyagte sanatan kalitad bhutaras bharam nivasatu nityam ihamrita nindini bindana madhurim saram. Hey Sanatan, your lotus feet put to shame the sweetness of heavenly nectar. Therefore, please make the bee of my mind undistracted by material desires and give me eternal residence at your lotus feet. This is my only prayer. So, one thing we can notice here that in all the verses he is praying for mercy. Why he is praying for mercy so much? And then there's one verse in the Shastras, it says, Ataha Sri Krishna Namadi Nabhaved Grahyam Indriye Sevan Mukohi Jivado Swameva Spurtela. That the transcendental name of the Lord, which is identical with the Lord, is non-different, it's completely transcendental, and because it's transcendental and spiritual, it's not possible for a conditioned soul to utter this name with material senses and material mind. It's not possible. Only by its causeless mercy, or by the causeless mercy of the devotee of the Lord, this name comes and dances on the tongue of a devotee. Now, when it comes, still, it's so delicate in the nature. It's very sensitive. And even if we commit a little bit of offense against either devotee or devotion or God Himself Krishna, then it will vanish very quickly. So we need mercy at all points. Constantly we have to pray for mercy. Constantly we have to hold on tight to the lotus feet of our Gurudev Vaishnavas and pray hard and hard that if they allow, then for sure always we can be merged in this ocean of bliss and in this humble attitude, and that we should respect everybody and we should see our insignificant position, and in comparison to that, when we see that these things where we want, the realm where we want to go is so vast and so difficult, so only their mercy is hope for us. So when we continuously pray, then certainly Lord will be merciful, and his devotees, they are also even more merciful than him, then there's some hope for us. So I will not take some more of the time, and we'll hear from you.
So we should try to learn the processes of chanting Hari Name, the process of our prayer to Krishna, our prayer to Govardhan, our prayer to Radhakund, or prayer to devotees, or prayer to Gurudev. These are the process. Not like that, oh God, give me bread and butter. Oh God, give me very beautiful wife, very beautiful husband, so good child, so wealth, reputation. It will come by your impressions of past lives. So don't be worried for this. These are all anartha. These are problems and some difficulties in the way of bona fide love. We are told something. I told in walking, what is the difference between sin and aparadha? Sin related to body and mind, but aparadha, they are very much related to soul. So if you do aparadha, aparadha, two words, Aratmane affection will go out. Atmane will go out. And then our bhakti and everything, sadhavi, uprooted. So we should be very careful. If you have no aparat, but yet you have some anarths. Anarth means na artha iti anartha. What is here? The meaning of artha?
Benefit.
Yes, like this. What we want and how we will be happy. I will have to come to this miserable, full of sufferings, ego and all these things in this world. So those who are like badha,
obstacles
in this, these are called anartha. If there is no aparadha, but yet it may be the anarths. So I told anishchita bhakti perhaps in morning,
yesterday.
Six kinds of utsahamayi ghantarla and all I will explain. If they are gone away, even four kinds of anarth are there. And even there are four are gone, again four are there. Then the saddha will be nishtha. And then, or after that you will do, it will be nishtha. But there are four and four, he will explain. To listen it very carefully. If you are aware and you are given up all these anarth, then your bhakti will be bona fide. And the gate of bhakti will be open for you and you can enter. Otherwise you cannot enter. Always involving coming, going in these anarths. So you should know and careful for this.
ओज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्वदिनाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे एट फर्स्ट I prostrate my humble dandavat pranam, the lotus feet of Gurudev, and after that, humble dandavat pranam to all Vaishnavas. Please mercy on me, I can fulfill Srila Gurudev's desires. Just you have heard from Gurudev's lotus mouth that sin and aparad, quite different, sins related with body and mind, and aparad related with soul. About this aparad, Gurudev has explained today during to morning walk. Vaishnava aparad is very dangerous. It's uprooted the creeper of bhakti. So we have to be aware from Vaishnava aparad. Gurudev explained today also that in Nama aparad, 10 kinds of Nama aparad. Why not explain as before Guru Avagya? Why at first Satang Linda? Because we think always that, oh, I am Vaishnava, he is also Vaishnava. Sometimes we do joke, oh, sometimes don't neglect him like this. So there is so many chance for Vaishnava aparad. Sometimes we criticize another Vaishnava, but Gurudev is Gurudev, so we have some opulence and some so much regards for him. So there is very rare chance to do aparad in his lotus feet, but sometimes we neglect, sometimes cannot carry his order like this. So we have to beware from this aparad. So Gurudev explained yesterday about Anishthita Bhakti, that means Samai Ghanatarala, just you have heard about 2 minutes before. After that, there is more anartha is there. If there is no aparad, yet some anartha. It is called loy, vikshep, apratipatti, kasar, rasasad. Loy means go to the sleep. That's like kirtan, shravan, smaran. If you do kirtan, we have to all do kirtan, then we are doing kirtan. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, just like trampoline. We are jumping on the trampoline like this. Then there is no chance of sleep at all. But when you hear, I hope that you have hear from Gurudev, if somebody is going to the sleep, Gurudev told, don't go to the sleep. Because everywhere Maya is too all around this world with his two girls, Eon and Laziness. If you take shelter of all and don't listen carefully, then Maya will send his two daughters at first, thereafter she will come and you make you sleep. So you can't hear Harikatha. So during Kirtan, it will sleep not come very easily. But during Shravan, there is so lot of chance for sleepness. After that, Kirtan, Shravan, Smaran. When you remember, mainly when we chant our Gayatri Mantra, Gurudev told that we don't think about any material thing during chanting our Gayatri Mantra and another thing. So try to engage your mind fully. You can involve your mind the pastimes of Krishna and Mahaprabhu during chanting your Gayatri Mantra. At that time, sleep comes very easily. So gradually, shravan, more than shravan to kirtan, at first kirtan, after that, more in shravan, more in smaran, sleep comes, it is called loy. This is one kind of anartha. That are big shape. Gurudev is giving lecture, we want to hear, I want to follow Toto. But sometime, I hear, sometime could not hear. Sometime mind go another anywhere else. Vikchep means specially, chep means obstacle. So you will not follow his lecture totally. Sometimes Gurudev asks, oh, what shall I tell just now? Can you explain? Oh, Gurudev, I can say. Why not? Because we could not hear attentively his whole words. It is called vikchep. Apratipatti. Apratipatti means there is strong desire to do all these things, that means Navavidha Bhakti, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnam, Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasya, Sakhamatma, Nivedanam. Iti Pungsar Pita Vishnu Bhaktischana Valakhana, Kriyed Bhagavat Taddha, Tanmanyaditam Uttamam. We want to do at our best, that we shall hear from Gurudev and Vaishnavas, who is superior to me. And Kirtan, small everything in 9 parts of devotion. After that, in Shastra is strongly announced that Sadhu Sangha Nam Kirtan Bhagavat Shravan Mathura Vasi Murti Shraddha Sevan. That if we do these five kinds of devotion, then Srila Rupa Goswami Pada is explaining in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, the nectar, in his book Nectar of Devotion, that Durhadhute Virjasmin Shraddha Duryastu Panchake Jatka Salpa Visammanda Sadhyam Bhava Janmane. If there is no offense, if he is very simple, if there is any kind of connection about these five, then easily he can get bhav. We heard from Gurudev, we try to hear, try to obey his order, try to do kirtan, try to smaran. There is strong desire, yet we could not follow it. It is called apratipatti. Have desire but could not do. Apratipatti. Kasai. Kasai means fault. That I am doing bhajan, but there is some another desire has come in my mind. It is called kasai. Just like Narad Rishi, when at his first life was son of Dasi, and after his mother expired, don't care for his mother, dead body, he went there for bhajan. Narad Rishi want that being in forest, I shall do bhajan. But he has not strong desire that I should do bhajan, I should satisfy Krishna at any cost, at any means. But he has desire that being in his forest, I want to do bhajan of Krishna. So, it is one kind of kasai. Because you know that city or town is rajasic, village is tamasic, and to live in forest is sattik, and mon niketanastu nirgunam. That means temple where bona fide Vaishnava and Gurudev is there, under guidance is living in temple, it is called Nirgun Vas. Naradasi want to be in sattik vanavas. So this is one kind of kasai. When God give him darshan, thereafter he just like lightning and disappear. And sound came from sky. Oh, this lifetime you cannot get more darshan because you have some kasai. Kasai means little fault. So we have to be careful from this kasai also. And rasasad, during sravan, kirtan and smaran, there is some taste. Test means material test come in our mind. Sometimes we are chanting our Gayatri, that my mind goes some soup. Oh, I have seen as before very good soup. I have to purchase this. Or sometimes I have seen in market, oh, very good drink. Oh, I have to purchase at any cost. I am chanting. Gurudev given a mantra, but my mind, this kind of material desires coming in my mind is called rasasa. That means during Savan Kirtan Smaran, if material test came in my mind, it is called rasasa. After that, if it will go, if there is some anartha, as before Utsavami Ghanatara it is thick, after that it is thin, and after that some anartha, yet it is more thinner than as before. It is called Sukriti Uttha Anartha, Duskriti Uttha Anartha, Bhakti Uttha Anartha, Aparad Uttha Anartha. Sukriti means pious activity. Duskriti means bad activity. And Aparad means we have heard as before Aparad. And Bhakti Uttha means due to Bhakti. Gradually, I want to explain. Sukriti Uttha. In past birth, we have done so many activity. Just like somebody has done, dig so many ponds for taking bath, and there is very far away so many village. When pilgrims go through this way, they can take drink water there, they can take a bath there. For them, they have dig very, very big pond. Somebody made hospital, school. It is due to these things, now he is enjoying so many things. It is called Sukriti Uttha Anartha. And Duskriti Uttha Anartha, for these things he could not fix his mind totally in the devotee, devotion and devotional practices. duskriti yukta anartha. In past birth, we have done so many bad activities. For this, somebody is suffering. For disease, so many kind of disease. This time, he has no bad karma at all. Yet, you know, some child take birth, from birth is blind. Somebody dumb, somebody lame. Why? Because he has done past birth very bad activity. Due to this, we are doing bhajan, but our mind could not fix totally in bhajan. This due to duskriti uttha anartha. And bhakti uttha anartha, before pure devotion, it is called aparabhakti. Due to aparabhakti, so many name, fame, reputation came. If we think that it is due to my bhakti, oh, I have done so many devotions, so it is come. If we involve in these things, then we will go far away from devotion. If due to aparabhakti, if any kind of name, fame, reputation came, we have to reconcile this, that it is not due to my bhakti. My bhakti is not pure. It is impure bhakti, it is aparabhakti. It is due to Gurudev's mercy. So Gurudev is owner of this name, fame and reputation. We never desire for a name, fame and reputation. Due to the influence of Gurupad Padma, it's come to me. But I am not owner of this, I am not enjoyer of this. Gurudev is enjoyer and he, what he likes, he can do. I am not qualified for this. If we involve, we have to go far away from devotion. And aparaduttha. If we not want yet, some kind of aparad scheme
can come
due to so many circumstances. We don't want to criticize any Vaishnavas. Sometimes come, oh, he is very bad person. I don't know about him at all. I never do association with him at all. Yet, circumstances come, we bound to say like this. So it is aparaduttha anartha. So we have to be aware from this anartha. If we, by mercy of Guru and Vaishnava, remove of this by anarthas, beyond of this anarthas, then steadiness, then nistha will come. So we have to pray regularly, lotus feet of Gurudev, Vaishnava, and just like Gurudev told us, Govardhan, Krishna, Srimati Radharani, and his associates. If we pray regularly, just like in Manasiksha also told, that Sarupam Sirupam Tasakvajam Isputam Premna Smaranam Tadadam Srinumana. If we do so, then we will be across this anartha very easily, and by mercy of, causeless mercy of Gurudev, we can advance in devotion. So, if we beyond this, then steadiness will come. After that, Ruchi, Asakti, so many steps, and they have also different deviation. So we shall hear all these things from Srila Gurudev. Hare Krishna. Vancha kalpataru bhascha kripa sindhu bhayeva cha patitanam pavanibho
vishnu guru namo namo Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Taraya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tada Bhaktaya Namo. I have heard Namaparat, Shivaparat, also eight kinds of anarths. They are all dangerous. Namaparat is most dangerous. And after that, four are dangerous but not so much. We should try to avoid all these things. After that, nishtha comes. Nishtha means to kya ek jagah mein man ko sthir karna.
Concentrate our mind at one point.
Where is that problem? What?
Concentrate our mind at one point.
In Krishna bhakti. That is nishtha. But
it concerned to mind, to Nishtha. And it concerned that we should do or not. So concerning to mind. And this is our sadhana. If this nishtha is matured, automatically ruchi, meaning taste, coming. Tastes are of two kinds. If deities are so well decorated, ornamented, oh, how beautiful the deities are. And if not decorated, they are naked like, they are dirty. Thakurji is not good. We should go to there. There is a golden deity there, and we should see. Golden thrones, golden ornaments, and golden everything. So glittering deities are there. So we will go there. In Vrindavan, now it is. Anyone don't go to bona fide deities like Govind, Gopinath, Madan Mohan. No pratishtha, nothing to other temples, very decorated. Golden and all these things are there, so glittering, all the lights have been given. Thakurji is feeling hot, everything, but yet, oh, very. And bring out all persons, relation. Oh, come on, see this deities. Very good deities. Where there is kirtan, but not like an instrument, no mridanga or mridanga, but he don't want to play good on mridanga. And his voice is not so sweet. No, kirtan is not. We should go on. In fact, the instruments are there. Very sweet tone is there. And in so many ways, oh, bona fide kirtan. All the teachers who want to teach, cheat.
Cheat.
All the cheaters collected there. And they want to cheat off. Artificially, they are doing all these things. Sometimes they take cigarette, also go inside and take wine, and coming dancing so, and so beautifully decorated, long, long hairs, cut hairs, and they are doing all. Oh, very good kirtan, bona fide. There are no tilak, no kanti mala, no pure devotees. And where there is very pure devotees, he may be Mahabhagavat, but he has no sweet voice and no instrument there. And he is telling, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. And weeping, trembling. But they thought, oh, he is cheater. They are not cheater. But he cheated. Because he has no sweet voice, but he has heart, pure devotion. So these are two kinds of ruchi, taste. He will go there, where there is so artificial things first. And where there is no artificial, it may be that he will be cheated. He will not hear that thing. So we should be careful for this. If there is a ruchi to kirtan, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard anywhere, Geet Govind was going on in Puri. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard that song, Jai Jai Deva Hare, Jai Jai Deva Hare. Jai Jai Deva Hare, जय जय देव हरे श्री तकुचम कुंडल दलजे धित कुंडलये कलित ललित बनमा जय जय देव हरे एनी वाज सिंगिंग हु वाज सिंगिंग देवदासी ऑफ जगन्नाथ very far away in any jungle, but its thrones were there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, forget who is he, his male or not female, and he ran towards them. Oh, Krishna, Krishna, where you are? He was running so fast that anyone cannot pursue him. So Govind was telling that, oh, Mahaprabhu, this family is singing, you should not touch her. Otherwise, I know that you will fall in, jump in she. So, hear me, let me hear. But he was not hearing. Then he very loudly told, what you are doing? This lady, devotee is singing. You should not embrace at once. He stood up and told, Govindu has said to me, otherwise you are touched. I must jump in she and give him my life. Once in the midnight, Annie was singing very far away, Jagannath temple, this very song, written by Jayadeva Goswami, in Gita Govind. Jagannath there came out of the temple, and it was locked five and more than that, so many walls, very strong, and they were sealed, but Jagannath went out. In thrones, he has scratches in his body and clothes were torn. In morning, when they opened the gate and saw that there are so many scratches in the body of Jagannath Dev and clothes were worn and torn, then why it became? And they became so worried. They went to the king and king that saw that we have done something wrong and we have done some aparad. Then he began to do stalls. In the dream, in the night, he saw that. Oh, my song was going over there and I went to here. I could not check up my song. And so in thorns, the scratches came. From that day, king won that anyone should sing this kirtan in night anywhere. What is this? If there is no voice, good, but yet the Krishna kirtan is going on, he will hear the Krishna name and he will at once fall flat in the earth. So, we should know carefully all these things and try to have a ruchi. If there is no tal swar, means no voice, good voice, sweet swar, even we should try to honor the persons who have ruchi. And after this, it is bona fide and matured, then ashakti comes. Ashaktis are also of two kinds. Asakti to bhajan and asakti to bhajaniyam, and that is the Krishna and his associates. First, this will come. Right? Asakti to attachment, so much attachment to sadhan bhajan. Without sadhan bhajan, he cannot remain. His life and soul is bhajan. And after that, it will turn to transfer to asakti to Krishna and he is the associate. We should try to follow all these things. We should know all these things. And then Shuddha Bhakti will come and we will progress there. Now you can hear some Chaitanya Charitamrita. This is Shabhan. We are going to establish what is the goal of our bhajan. And then we should determine that what is our life's or Shabhan bhajan's goal. If it is fixed, then we should do Shabhan. What is Shabhan for that? If you want a Rasagulla, where we should go? In the shop of Rasagulla. If you are going to sabji market means? You can't have this. If you are going to college to purchase this, in medical college, engineering college, you can't have this. You'll have to go in the Rasagulla shop and easily. But if you have no to payment, then you will see and some water will come. And then return. So we are going to at first see that what is the goal of our sadhana bhajan. Why that? What we want. And then we will discuss about the means and the practice by which it can be attained. I have told up to he is telling that the affection of gopis towards Krishna, the love for gopis to Krishna is the highest goal. He told that, requested that you should go on forward. If there is anything, then he told the affection and love of Srimati Radhika is best among all. So the Shakti is Radhika's love affection to Krishna. Krishna has also affection for Srimati Radhika or gopis, but it is not our goal. Because Radhika, affection and love for Krishna, it is ultimate. More superior than to Krishna love to gopis. It all narrated from Srimad Bhagavatam. That Krishna played on the full moon day in the evening. The whole forest was glooming so much. Glooming means?
Blossoming.
The sky was reddish because reddish moon was coming. And at that time, Krishna played on his flute. And all gopis came there. All were charmed. There were so many persons, male and female, but they could not listen. Only gopis listened. And they came there. Then, Krishna told that you should return to home and serve your husbands. Whether he is lame, he is so wretched, even so poor, ugly, making no money, no hope, you should try to serve your husband. This is our Vedic culture. his husband is doing something wrong, but he Sanatana Dharma, his wife's servant. If he is also leprosy, but you serve. So you should return to your lives. Krishna showed so many examples, but they never returned. And I have told how they cut the arguments of Krishna, and dance was going on there. At last, Krishna was doing rash, singing and dancing with them. Krishna became, as there were gopis, thousands of thousands gopis. So Krishna became thousands of thousands Krishna. And he began to dance with each gopis. Two Krishna, one gopi. Or two gopis in the middle?
One Krishna.
One Krishna. She was dancing. And in the middle, Srimati Radhika was dancing with Krishna also. He was moving and dancing so fast, as if you can take a burning stick and do like this, then it will be round.
Fire round?
Yes. And you will see that there is a light like this, round. But not round. She is a piece of burning wood. Srila Bhagavan Krishna was one, but he was dancing so fast that all realized that Krishna is with me, dancing, doing like this, and postures. They all saw Krishna is only with me, not with anyone. Only with me he is dancing. And he is doing so, dancing by and serving that gopi. Oh, you are tired? May I message? Oh, yes. This ring has gone there.
I took that.
And he took it and went it here. He took his
pitambar
and washing their sweats. So affectionate, Srimati Radha Sha. That, oh, he's so clever. When I see to me, he is with me. And when I see there, oh, she's playing with that gopi. Oh, that gopi. Obviously, she is very clever. At once, she was angry somewhat. He thought that I should not join this rush. Krishna saw and took Srimati Radhika. At once stolen Srimati Radhika and took away the forest. All gopis were watching. Where Krishna? Where Krishna? They are not saying that Radha has also gone with him. And Krishna has taken him. So all were weeping. Searching Krishna, not to Radha. Here and there. They became mad at once. They began to ask from trees, oh, you have seen my beloved Krishna? Oh, his milk, that is why he is taking the paksha of Krishna. He is taking the side of Krishna. He will love. Oh, he is so happy. They went to any creeper and full of, that creeper was full of
flowers.
Oh, she is so pleased. She had, surely Krishna has touched them and went through this way. Oh, you have seen my beloved? He was with me, with us, and now he has gone anywhere else. Have you seen? Oh, they are laughing, seeing us. Oh, Krishna had told that don't declare fair. So that is why they are not speaking. They are overjoyed. Moving like this, they were going here and then, weeping, weeping, weeping. Where you are, Krishna? Here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling to Ramananda that Krishna took an stolen Srimati Radhika from the group of, from the council of all dancing gopis. Clearly, and in their front, he could not take apparently to Srimati Radhika that he sees the best among all the gopis. Because he was fearing from all the gopis. Because they had promised that to each that you are most beloved to him. That gopi, oh, you are most beloved to I only have love for you. To that gopi. All each gopi used to know that Krishna loves you. So it will be clear and then they will know that, oh, he is cheater. So he has stolen away Srimati Radhika and went anywhere. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that, from your telling it is not apparent, clear, that Radha is more superior than all gopis. You should make clear this. Then he told another slok. Kansari Rapi, Baddha Shinkhala. That means, Jayadeva Goswami has written one book, you know, Gita Govinda. Very near and dear to Krishna. Jaya Jayadeva Hari is the first song. In this, it has been written, Jayadeva Goswami has realized and written that Ras was going in Govardhan. There is Chandra Sarovar, where moon stood up for lakhs and lakhs years there, watching the Rash. When Rash ended, then he went. So it is called Chandra Sarovar. Rash was not for only one night, for 12 hours or 6 hours. So long. Lakhs and lakhs years. So, dance was going on and Srimati Radhika felt that Krishna has ordinary affection and love like all the gopis to me. So he became angry. She left the rash and she went away. Krishna leaving all the gopis and he followed Srimati Radhika. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, oh, now it is clear. Among all gopis, 8 gopis are prominent. And in 8, 2, Chandrali and Radhika. And among 2, Radhika is supermost. But you should not think that Chandrali and all the gopis are separate gopis. All are Kaya view of bodily expansion of Srimati Radhika. For Bilash, Leela, past times, Srimati Radhika has taken all the shapes. So we should know that Radhika is supermost among all the gopis. So Krishna has told, Napareham niravadya sanyujan Sasadu Krityang Vibudajusa Piva Ma Bhajana Durujara Greha Singhala Sambrisya Tadva Pratijatu Sadhuna. In Rash Krishna told, don't be angry at me. I have been disappeared. Don't think like so. I am ungrateful. Because there were some reasons. Gopi asked to Krishna, after Krishna again appear. Gopis asked a question to him. Gopis were asking to Krishna, our beloved. We are putting a question, you can answer. And you should tell that what we are asking, properly you should answer. There are so many persons doing prem, loving to other person. And he is also, we can also have love affection for each other. So one loves anyone, male or female. And once that he should also love
me.
He should repay me. And another kinds of person are that. Whether anyone love or no, no love, have no love. They will love. And third class, you love or not love, they will love no one, anyone. Understand? The person, they want to love anyone if reciprocal is there. And some, you love or not, they will love. And thirds, you love or not, they will not, never love anyone. And ask a question, among these, you are in what category? They wanted to fall Krishna in that trap. That Krishna should accept that he is guilty. So what kind of guilty he is? Gopis wanted to take Krishna in that category. Krishna told, smiling, very gently, having some shame. Clothes were wrapped here, like he is leaning. And he is telling, very humbly he is telling, those who want to love, in exchange of love, they are no actually love. They are businessmen. To make money, they sell anything, they take that what price and they sell. For those who want to love anyone, that he should also love me, she should also love me. This is really nothing. Only business. No religion, no truth, nothing is there, no quality is there. Only they are businessmen. I am not in this category. That and next. He told that they love all, they don't want, and it should love or not love, but they love, like father and mother, like guru. Lakshan, they want to love their children, not their father and mother. Worldly love goes
down.
And this goes, benefit love goes up towards Krishna. So much difference in that. Krishna told, guru and father and mother, all kinds of guru, they, whether anyone love or not, the sons are disciples, but he will love. And I know that you are in that category. Whether I love you or not, but you love me. Here there is truth. And really, it is love, affection. But I am not in this category also. And thirdly, there are four kinds of these persons. You love or not, they will not love. Those who worship the Kaam, Aptakam. Those who are, all kinds of desire have been fulfilled. No desire is there. whether you, because they don't want to gain anything. They have no any worldly desire at all. So if you love or not love, they will not love. Like Shukdev Goswami, like Sanakshanandam Sanat Kumar, they don't want even a cloth to cover their all these things. They don't want bread, butter, anything. They are not depending to anyone. They are always realizing in their soul, and always they cannot take a meal for lakhs and lakhs years. They don't want the air also. No heat, no sun, nothing. So if you go and love, will go your whole wealth, chintamani you will get. No need. Your all kinds of desire have been fulfilled. Then you love or not love, they don't care. Aptakam and Aptaram. Aptaram means those who are always satisfied in their Atma, seeing always and so happy there. They have no influence of Maya at all. And they don't know this body and all these things. They have nothing to do with all these material things. They don't know life and to birth and death and all sufferings and sorrow. They are quite above all. So, with worldly love, affection, rapture and all these things, they have nothing to do. After that, one kind of, that those who are akritagya. Akritagya means?
Ungrateful.
Ungrateful. Ungrateful creatures. Like, there is a scorpion. He was floating in the
river
and he was going to die. Sometimes sinking and suffering. A sadhu came, a Vaishnava came, and he took up. He took up and began to take him out of water. But he did so, and it was gone in again water. Again he took, again he did like this. 3 times, 4 times. Then his friend told that, why you are doing so? Then this sadhu was telling, told him, that if he will not
leave his nature,
I will not change my nature also. He should cut, and I will save him. At last he said. So Vaishnava are like Haridas Thakur was beaten in 22 markets and he was about to die. But he was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So we should not change all these moods. So Krishna is telling, akritagya, those who are akritagya, ungrateful to their father, mother and gurus and anyone. You love or not love, they will not. Some like have an example like this. Father and mothers are too old. They cannot do anything. The son is married and he has 2-3 children. The old man doing khasi, cold, in night, and some disturbance for her children and for her. But they were, all the wealth was for this old person coming from there. Very big house, so much wealth, everything was there due to his father. But now he was disrespecting, dishonoring. that one, oh, why he is not going to die? Whole day and night he is coughing, like this. Whole time. We have no sleep. But he is not remembering. These are ungrateful creatures, like animals. But I am not in this category. You know? If I was like that, then I would not have been appeared again. But I have appeared. And I am not Satta. Atmaram or Atmakam. Because I called you. And now I am dancing and doing, or I am carrying your all orders. So I am not Atmaram or Atmakam. I am not Atmaram. Why? I used to be angry with my mother when he gives me
her grace.
He, for any reason, he used to keep me and I become angry. So, it is not the symptom of Shakta, Atmakam or Atmaram. Sometimes I tell lie. I have not eaten earth. Sometimes angry. Sometimes I am weeping. These are not the symptoms of Atmaram or Atmakam. And now I have come, so I am not ungrateful to you. So be pleased with me. And last, Guru Drohi. Guru Drohi meaning? Not letting, doing offense to their Gurudev and father and mother. They are Guru Drohi. If Guru is loving, having so much affection, but they will have no. That. But I am not any of among these. You know that you are my beloved. I am your beloved. I have only gone out of sight that what you are doing in my absence. And whole world will know that they became mad for Krishna. I wanted to
show the
glories. Your glories only. Na pareham nirvadya sanjujan. Our meeting is so sacred. And I cannot repay you in long lives like demigods, lakhs and lakhs years. Gopi told me, you can repay? How can I repay? Because you have bona fide love for me. My affection and love is distributed among all the living beings in the whole world. There are lakhs and lakhs and kotis, innumerable devotees. So I have to also some affection to them. So my affection and love is divided to all. But your?
Single-pointed.
Only to me. So that if I want, that I want to repay, but I cannot repay. What is your fine? Because you ask me that give a benediction that we can serve you more. Understand this? If Krishna will tell that, take any benediction, ask what you want, gopis will tell. Only this. We want only this benediction that we should serve you. And if you will serve, I will be more and more
indebted.
So I cannot do this. I know that you are so much qualified. I cannot repay, but you can repay only. How? He cannot repay. You will, by your qualification, you will forgive me. And so, not fallen, but not so much affection as you have. So you should forgive me. I cannot do it. Gopis are, oh, you have conquered me. We are defeated. Because you have accepted your defeat. Now you have defeated by this thing, that I have been defeated by you. So we are now defeated. Krishna told that, excuse me. What I have done? I have done for your glorification in the whole world. That none are like you. So this is the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. Gopi has no ambition, anything that Krishna should love or not love. They are loving Krishna. Krishna cannot love like gopis. Have affection and love for Krishna. They are ornamenting themselves. They are doing?
Decorated themselves.
They are what?
Bread.
Everything. Having so much good flowers here and there. That Krishna will see us and he will become so glad and happy. And Krishna becomes happy, he is like Atmaram, no sorrow, no gladness, nothing, but he will be happy to make gopis happy. Each other that. They don't want anything to be paid. So, this is the highest goal, affection like gopis. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told me, yes, I am satisfied. How to have this kind of affection and love to Krishna? Then he told something and we will explain another day. But you should must know that Srimati Radhika's affection was supernova and all. We cannot imagine how kind of love. But also religion. The religion of Atma is the same thing, same love. But not so bhikkhu.
Broad.
Unlimited broad. Fraction love.
Yeah.
Because we are not body of Krishna or Srimati Radhika. We are separated from Krishna. Part and parcel of Krishna. So our affection and love is also part and parcel. So, we should try our hard thing. Not to be pleased in this world. Not to collect so much things because you will have to keep here and go. Where to go we don't. So we should try more and more to develop out this love from Shraddha to Nishtha, Ruchi, Asakti, Bhav, Prem, Sneha, Man, Pranay, Rag, and Pranaya. Following the footsteps of Sadhguru. Only this is, only this is the way. If you want liberation, you can have, you can exercise your mental all these things and think that I am Brahma. This is process. And goal is liberation. If you want to serve Narayan, then you can practice Shravanam, Kirtanam, or Dharma with Vaidhiva. If you want to go more than that, then you should try to serve Rukmini and Saptabhama in Dwarkadish and Jagannath Puri, in Jagannath Baldeshwar. If you want more like Sakha, then you can follow Siddham Subhadra Madhumanda Lord. If you want to love Krishna like father and mother, like Yashoda and Nanda, you will have to follow them. And if you want to love affection like Gopi, then you will have to follow them. And you can have. We will explain. Go Prima.
Yesterday night you told Gajahanta Prabhu that you would tell everyone the story of how the gopis met Durvasa Muni across the Jamuna.
Perhaps you know.
Actually, I have another question tonight.
Once, Gopis wanted to meet Durvasa Rishi. He was first yogi, Brahma yogi, and he was so powerful. If he gave course that you should die, anyone can die. So he was very powerful. He used to live across Jamuna. Now we had given that land and that temple 5,000 years, and now you are going to manage building new temples and everything.
We have to construct.
So the gopis wanted to meet Durvasa. Gopis prepared so many kinds of meal, delicious things, and they took it in very big golden pots. And they saw that we cannot cross Jamuna because it was flowing in very big current. The boats were not going because they will be drowned. So they asked Krishna how to cross Jamuna. A very easy thing. You should tell Jamuna, but Krishna Brahmachari, you should chant this mantra, Krishna Brahmachari, Krishna Brahmachari. He had never seen any woman or lady, and he had not connected to any, no relation at all. He had not seen any woman in his whole life. That he should easily cross. Gopis began to smile, and we should test it to the end. To Jamuna, and they told Krishna Brahmachari. If he is Brahmachari, never seen, no connection, no relation with any ladies, then we should cross. And telling this, they began to walk over Jamuna River on foot. And they crossed. They went there and paid respect to Durvasa Rishi and get lakhs and lakhs dishes full of so good preparations. And they kept there. Durvasa Rishi saw and he took like this. In a moment he took all. No remnant was there, not a single thing, puri or mishti or anything. Clean, almost clean. Then they do pranam to all to rishis, and they told to Rishi, we want to cross the river Jamuna, and there is so big flood and current, there are no boats. How you can? Krishna told a mantra and he was telling that Krishna is Brahmachari, Krishna is Brahmachari. And telling this, we crossed the river. Krishna has told us to do so. So we have done and crossed the river. Oh, you want to cross the river? So you should tell Jamuna. Durvasa Nirahari. Durvasa is Nirahari. He has not taken anything for even his low whole life, he had not taken water, anything. Then we should cross. And tell him, they began to walk on the river. And they crossed. Then they came to Krishna and began to laugh and clap him. That you are a cheater and we have met your guru. He's a great teacher. Yeah. Both you are saying.
Like you like this, I do.
Can you explain? That you are telling that we have no relation, we have never seen, we have come from the womb of any woman. We know this, that you have come from any woman. And you are telling no relation. And you cannot live without any woman, any moment. Always gopi, 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 gopi. And we cross telling this. We know that this is not true, but we cross. And he took all these things, dishes. Bilkul chat kar gaya. He
clean,
taking all things. No remaining was there. And he is telling that, I've never taken in whole life, then you can cross. And we cross the river. How it is? Krishna told. Certainly, it is true, quite true. I don't see any woman. Never. I have no lust. I have love and affection from all. And Durvasa Rishi is like saying, what he takes, gives to me. He never takes for him. Nothing for him. What he does, what he takes, what he smells, what he does, he gives to me. So he does not take. It is true. And I have no like connection. So I have no relation with women's are anything. Then they knew this fact. They know this fact. But for us, their question, Krishna replied. Krishna has told in Gita, Nateshu, Nateshu aham. I'm doing everything. I'm fighting, I'm taking, I'm with all these things, but not entangled in anything. Like sun gives rays to all, but not attached to anyone. Air, water, they are not attached to anyone. If you go and that, then you will die. No hot, no can to. There is so heat in sun, you may die, you may not die. Sun has nothing to do, nothing to gain and to give. He is unaffected. So Krishna is more than that. So we should know all these things and serve Krishna pure hearted. Gaur Prema.
Hari Hari
Yusufan Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And then you should be prepared for Aarti. Then Tulsi Parikrama.
Ki bajayo.